stay tuned for tonight's special report on uniformitarianism. When we take a look at ancient man, and we look at archaeology, politics, and we look at the reality of what we can actually see, hear, taste, touch, and smell, it runs contrary to what we've been taught, what we learn, and what our glossy, four-colored textbooks tell us in our colleges and in our high schools. So is there an answer to this? And I would contend that, yes, there is. There are liars, there are damn liars, and then there's statisticians. That's what Mark Twain said one time. Now, many times people are in error, and they repeat the error. That's innocent, and that's understandable. But when people repeat an error that they know to be an error, then that's a lie. And many of these people have a motive involved, and it deals with money, prestige, jobs, politics, and those are what we call damn liars. So I'd like to expose some of the damn liars for you, and let's start off here with a process or a program that's called the Big Bang. Now, you've heard of the Big Bang. That's where there's a period at the end of this sentence, and that period contained all of the mass and matter in the entire universe. Everything that you see, our sun, our moon, our planet, and all the planets in our solar system, and all the stars, and all the planets, and all the comets, and everything that you see in our Milky Way galaxy. And then all of that combined with all of the galaxies of the universe, and the quasars, and the black holes, and all of that. As far as you can see out for 12.5 billion light years, and then with the improvements on Hubble, all that you can see from 12 to 25 billion light years out, and then, like as not, everything else that's out past that that we can't see and don't even know if it exists. And all of that was condensed into something as small as the period at the end of the sentence. Now, I've never seen anything in the Bible to compare with a fairy tale like that. You know, that sounds like once upon a time, far, far away, there was a period at the end of a sentence, and it contained all of the mass and matter in the universe. I don't know. I'm just repeating here what it says here on the page. I'm not pulling your leg. I couldn't dream this up. I haven't got a mind that thinks in those kinds of insane terms. Now, these people are called science and scientists, and when they speak, we all listen. If somebody questions them, they're looked upon as being illiterate savages, dragging their knuckles on the ground. There's something wrong with somebody that would question that precept or that principle of uniformitarianism. Let me repeat it to you again. Once upon a time, far, far away, in a land long ago, there was a period at the end of the sentence, and it contained all of the mass and matter in the universe. Now, is that a fairy tale? Now, according to evolutionary philosophy, all life ultimately originated from a super explosion, and currently, many people believe that this mega blast happened some 12 to 15 billion years ago. Pause. Wait a minute. They said, many believe that this mega blast happened 12 to 15 billion years ago. May I interject? Why didn't it occur 24 to 30 billion years ago? Or 48 to 60 billion years ago? Or why didn't it occur 8,000 years ago or 3,000 years ago? Or, you know, many people believe, well, I'm one of many people, and I don't believe 12 to 15 billion years. I'm going to show you some evidence as we progress along. Here's my point. This 12 to 15 billion years is just speculation. it might as well be 15 to 18 billion years, or 27 to 36 billion years, or 35 to 42 million years, or 300,000 to 600,000 years ago. There isn't anybody that knows. And I've never seen a comment made anywhere or anybody ever said it occurred 12,387,447,618 years, 3 months, 14 days, 7 hours, and 6 minutes ago. The truth of the matter is, there isn't anybody that knows. Now, we've been given some information in the scripture that tells us roughly when it happened, about 6,000 years ago. I worked out the chronology, and I showed you this last week. It's 6,034 years, according to Pannon's chronology. It's pretty close to Usher's chronology. 6,034 years. That's what we can actually document from an ancient document that you could walk into court under the rules of evidence and present and have it accepted. But this idea that it occurred 12 to 15 billion years ago is just speculation. It's nothing more, it's nothing less. There's nothing wrong with the speculation. I mean, if that's what you want to believe, get after it. But it gets better than that. As time progresses along, these guys actually come down with numbers and dogmatic statements like, that's the way it is. And if you don't believe it, then you're uneducated. Going on, an infinitely tiny mass of matter somehow chanced to blow up, and things have been spinning off that explosion ever since. Can you tell me who was there at the time of the explosion? Can you tell me what experiments, what laboratory that was this demonstrated in? There's no evidence of it. It's many people believe. They believe it was a chance explosion. From then on, with random processes, everything in the universe became increasingly complex. The sun and all the other stars eventually condensed out of gas. The planets, including our Earth, also condensed out of dust particles swirling through space. Notice these dogmatic statements. Earth also condensed out of dust particles swirling through space. Excuse me? How do you know that the Earth didn't form from the blast of the explosion and form out of little pebbles that had been formed out of the dust and gas, or that it didn't break off of some bigger piece or mass? I mean, come on. You know, my mind is about as fertile as anybody else's, and I could think of all kinds of conjecture here. I would prefer to say, I don't know. I wasn't there. I wasn't alive at that time. I see what I observe today. And we're asking questions like, well, where did it come from? Some guy comes along and says, well, long, long ago, and far, far away, once upon a time, there was a period at the end of the sentence. All right, guys. Now, you tell me that I'm dragging my knuckles on the back of the ground. A fairy tale is a fairy tale, and all of us love once upon a time and far, far away, but that isn't where reality is located, is it? Now, let's ask an important question here. Do explosions ever increase order? Let's do a test. If you take a stick of dynamite and you go out and you blow up a pile of lumber or some other building material, is it going to end up more orderly? Or let's try it this way. Let's take a pile of lumber that's scattered. Or instead of the pile of lumber being stacked up, you know, in nice neat rows, like a unit of lumber is, let's take all the boards in there and let's just scatter them like a box of matches that you just tip upside down on the desk. And there it is. It's a pile of matches. And they're just headed and directed in every which way. Right. Now let's take this pile of lumber and let's put some dynamite under it and let's torch it off. Do you believe that if you were to explode dynamite under a pile of boards that they would fall down in an orderly stack like a unit of lumber is? Keeping in mind that all of those units of lumber are carefully piled up by an intelligent human being working on a green chain, taking one board at a time, and sliding it and piling it and very carefully putting it all together so that all the boards are headed in the same direction, and like as not, they're all the same length, and that's what we call a unit of lumber. Now, that's called design. Some intelligent being intends to stack the boards up, and he does just that. Do you believe that if you stuck a stick of dynamite under the pile of boards after it's been carefully stacked up and they're all the same length and they're all in the same direction, that it's going to make it more orderly? Do you believe that? Well, there are people that do believe that, and there are people that believe that the earth is flat. There's people that have all kinds of beliefs. But do these beliefs make it true? Is it true because these people believe it? If 50 million Germans believe something, does it make it true? We didn't think so when Hitler started World War II. We didn't believe that that was true just because 50 million Germans believed it. Did we?